Hi there, welcome back to my channel. Today we have an exciting video where we'll be diving into the world of high voltage lines. Imagine a super highway, but instead of cars, it carries electricity. That's what our 400 kilovolt line is. These lines are the backbone of our power grid, carrying huge amount of electricity over long distances. They are like the interstate highways of the electrical world, connecting power plants to cities and the towns. These lines are essential for our modern way of life. Without them, we wouldn't have the electricity to power our homes, businesses, and everything in between. 400 kilovolt lines are high voltage lines, meaning they operate at a much higher voltage than the electricity that comes out of our wall outlets. This high voltage allows for efficient transmission of power. Think of like this: a high voltage is like a wider pipe, allowing more electricity to flow through. These lines are carefully designed and maintained to ensure safety and reliability. But what happens when something goes wrong and a 400 kilovolt line needs to be disconnected? Suddenly, disconnecting a 400 kilovolt line is like slamming the brakes on a speeding train. The electricity flowing through the line doesn't just disappear, it needs somewhere to go. When a line disconnected, the flow of electricity is disrupted and it can have a ripple effect throughout the grid. Imagine a garden hose with a nozzle at the end. If you suddenly close the nozzle while the water is running, the pressure builds up the hose. This sudden interruption can cause voltage fluctuation. It's like turning off the main water supply to a city. Everyone feels the impact. Disconnecting a high voltage line isn't as simple as flipping a light switch. Remember that sudden interruption we talked about? That interruption can create something called an electrical arc. An electrical arc is powerful discharge of electricity through the air. It's like a miniature lightning bolt, incredibly hot and dangerous. Think like this: when you pull apart two charged electrical contacts, the electricity tries to jump to the gap, creating an arc. This arc produces intense heat and a light and can cause serious damage to equipment and pose a serious risk to everyone nearby. This is where circuit breakers come in. Circuit breakers are like safety valves of the power grid. They are designed to interrupt the flow of electricity in case of a fault or when a line needs to be disconnected. Think of the circuit breaker as a super fast switch that can open and close a circuit in a fraction of a second. When a fault is detected or a line needs to be disconnected, the circuit breaker springs into action, interrupting the flow of electricity and preventing the formation of a dangerous electrical arc. There are different types of circuit breakers, but one of the most common type used in high voltage applications is the SF6 gas circuit breaker. SFC circuit breaker, a gas power safety net, SFC6 or sulfur hexafluoride, is a special gas with incredible insulation properties. It's like an electrical superhero capable of quenching electrical arcs and preventing them from causing harms. In an SF6 circuit breaker, the contacts are surrounded by the SF6 gas. When the circuit breaker needs to interrupt the current, the contacts are separated and the SF6 gas blasts into the gap, extinguishing the arc and isolating the circuit. Think of like this: imagine the trying to start a fire in the room filled with carbon dioxide. The CO2 was smoother than the flames, preventing the fire from spreading. SF6 gas does the same painting for electrical arcs, effectively quenching them and protecting the power grid. These SF6 circuit breakers are essential for ensuring the safety and reliability operation of our power grid. They act as guardians of the grid, protecting us from the dangers of high voltage electricity. And that's it for this video. If you found it helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more awesome content. If you have any questions or topics you would like us to cover, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.